All right, here we are with Honda Goldwing Interstate 1200. Oh, and what the heck is up with that gap? That's where the carburetors go. So that's what I'm working on here. And this had... Sorry, I have a cough that is persistent and never wants to go away. So, basically, the issue I had is I actually rebuilt these carbs. I put all the jets in them. And I'm a noob, and I didn't know that I had to make sure that the specs on these floats were right. So basically I blew through a starter because this cylinder was filling up with fuel. Like 100%. Like when I pulled off the carburetor, when I popped this seal, fuel came out of that. And that's an intake manifold. And so this whole thing was full of fuel. And so isn't the cylinder. And this cylinder looks wet too. So anyways, my fault. But I looked online to see, like, you know, how you do this. And I'm gonna show you what I did. And if you're seeing this video, that means that this worked. Okay? So if you can see here, I saw a couple other videos where they had pulled the carburetors off this manifold. But man, I'll tell you what, there is a lot of things connecting these four carburetors. So, I mean, you got tubes, you got springs, you got all sorts of crap. So it would be a lot better if you can just do it with it attached. And so I took some of the other video advice and kind of came up with my own solution. And basically, let's see, it's very difficult to do with this giant thing, but basically we're gonna let these floats come out and then roll them back, and eventually they will stop at a certain point. Okay, now if you go back too far, they'll just sink in to their natural position. So what you gotta do is just drop them back until they stop, until it stops going in. Okay. So basically right now it's just sitting on that float needle in there. Hard to see. Okay, so once it just sits on there, but it just sitting on the needle, but not pushing it in. Okay, and what I'm gonna do for the purposes of this video is just set up my handy dandy flashlight. But that's basically exactly where it needs to be to measure it. So what what I did here is took a caliper and set it to 7.5 millimeters. This is a 1987 Goldwing Interstate 1200, so in case you want to know. So you take that, set it 7 millimeters, get it to the point where that float is just setting on the needle but not pushing it, and then slide this across. Basically, what you want is to be, oh my God, this cough. You want it to be as close as possible. See, slides right over the top. Not even a pube hair can fit in there. That's what you're looking for. So you want this thing to be at an angle where the floats touch the needle, but they're pushing the plunger, but they don't push the needle that's in the plunger. They're just setting there. And that's how you make your measurement. And mine were, which one is this one? This one was the worst. It was set way in. When I put this on there, oh my gosh, there was almost a quarter inch. So it was bad. I ended up changing the oil because this bike sat for a few months. And I went to go start it, wouldn't start. And come to find out, and I kept trying to start it, burned out the starter, which I have to replace, which is a pain in the ass. And then come to find out it was hydrolock. Yeah. Anyways. 4 carburetors on this freaking thing. Stupid. I don't know what engineer was like. Yeah, let's just slap 4 carburetors on this thing. Yeah, fuck yeah. Anyways, that's what I'm doing. And if it works, you'll see this video. If it doesn't, you'll never know it existed. Have a good night.